God bless you, loved ones. Welcome to the Word with Chester. Today we'll begin studying the 26th chapter of the book of Numbers. It is a very long chapter, so we're going to have to cut this particular chapter into maybe three, possibly four sessions. I'm going to do more reading today. For that being, God had commissioned Moses to number all of the people. They're getting ready, getting close to going in their land, so he wanted to number all of the people from 20 years old and upward. God had a reason for doing so. And we're going to read about that as we go. So I'm not going to do a lot of commentary today. It will be more reading. I ask that you pray for us on a daily basis, that God will get the glory out of what we do, and also grant the things that we need to further this ministry. I'll just share with you, I'm not asking you for cash money. Don't get me wrong. I'm not the type to beg you for your money. But I try to use my entrepreneurial skills to raise money. We're trying to raise $50,000 or so. I want to start traveling from city to city, a major city to major city, and do crusades throughout this country. As many of you know, that I'm also the Professional Truckers Association pastor. I hope to do this in the near future, start going from place to place, near truck stops and things of that nature, and set up a tent and just have a revival services, trying to reach the souls of men and women. I'm not asking you for money to do anything. I'm asking God to help me do this, and with your prayers, it will be done. I'll be honest with you, I will not be angry at anyone that want to donate a generator, a clean power generator to further this cause, or a tent that will hold 500 to 1,000 people. I won't be angry at you if you donate that, but don't get me wrong. I am not begging you for your money or asking you for anything except for your prayers and your help to make this ministry what it should be. I want to travel through this land with the gospel of Jesus Christ and just share the word with as many people as I possibly can. And it's not a hard thing to do. I want to organize ministers. I want to do all the preaching. I want to organize ministers and a team so that we can reach as many souls as possible through this ministry. With your help and your prayers, we can do that. Well, today we're going to read from verse 1 of chapter 26, and as I said, I will do more reading today. We'll be trying to pronounce a lot of names, and you bear with me if I stumble over a few, because some of these names are somewhat hard to pronounce, but God will give us strength. Remember what we're doing. We're reading completely through this Bible, verse by verse and chapter by chapter, and I'm giving commentary as we go. Those of you that's been with us know we started in the Gospel of St. Matthew, went completely through the New Testament scriptures, and now we're well on our way in the Old Testament passages of scripture. Please pray for us as we go to the Word of God. The Bible reads in verse 1 of chapter 26, "And it came to pass, after the plague, that the Lord spoke unto Moses and unto Eleazar, the son of Aaron, the priest, saying, Take the sum of the congregation of the children of Israel, from 20 years old and upwards, throughout their father's house, all who are able to go to war in Israel." Well, this was a commission from the Lord. Those of you that was not with us in our last settings, it would benefit you to read. They had just come through a time where they had displeased the Lord, and in displeasing the Lord, many of them died. I believe 24,000. Men died because they displeased the Lord. The Bible said they went to into harlotry with the children of Moab. But here, the Lord is letting them know, this is after they've come out of that plague and the things that transpired, to where, in so many words, that God spared them. They were back in good standing with God. And this God had told them to take the sum, or add up the congregation, all the congregation of the children of Israel, from 20 years old and upward, throughout their father's house, all who are able to go to war in Israel. Shall we continue reading? "And Moses and Eleazar the priest spoke with them in the plains of Moab, by the Jordan near Jericho, saying, take the sum of the people from 20 years old and upward, as the Lord commanded Moses and the children of Israel who went forth out of the land of Egypt. Now we're going to begin reading names here now, so bear with me. This may not be the most exciting part of the scripture because we're reading so many names, but I hope that every word in the Bible is important, and I encourage you to stay with us even through this section as we're reading God's word. The Bible reads, Reuben, the eldest son of Israel, in verse 5, the children of Reuben, Hanok, of whom which came the family of the Hanochites, of Paliu, the family of the Paluites, the Paluites. Well, shall we read? Or of Hezron, the son of the Hezronites, of Carmi, the son of the Carmites. These are the families of the Reubenites, and they who were numbered of them were 43,730. 43,730 people. Shall we continue reading? And the son of Paliu, Eliab, the son of Eliab, Nemuel, and Dathan, and Abiram, this is that Dothan of Abiram, who were chosen from the congregation, who strove against Moses and against Aaron in the company of Korah, when they strove against the Lord. Now, you remember reading that, those of you that's with us, and I do hold that you can always go back on our lesson and get intelligence of what we're talking about. Now, verse 20 verse 10, and the earth opened its mouth and swallowed them up together with Korah when the company died. Let me read that again. And the earth opened its mouth and swallowed them up together with Korah when the company died, when the fire devoured 250 men, and they became a sign. In other words, God used them as an example. They had a bad spirit that came out and rose up against God himself and rose up against Moses, saying so many words that, Moses, you're not the only one that God can see and God can use. We're all holy people. We're all this, that, and the other. And God opened up the earth and swallowed many of them up. Now let's read verse 11. Notwithstanding, the children of Korah died not. In other words, he did not wipe out all of the children of Korah. Well, you got to understand, some of them, many of them died, but he did not wipe them out. Notwithstanding, the children of Korah died not. The sons of Simeon, after their families, of Nemuel, the families of the Nemuelites, and Jamin, the families of the Jaminites, and Jachin, the families of the Jachinites. Verse 13 reads, of Zerah, the families of the Jerahites, of Sheul, the families of the Sheulites. Verse 14, these are the families of Simeonites, 22,200. 22,200. Now let's read on in verse 15. The children of Gad, after their families, of Zephon, the families of the Zephonites, and Haggai, the families of the Haggites, of Shunai, the families of the Shunites, of Oznai, the families of the Oznites, of Eri, the families of the Erites, of Arab, the families of the Aradites, of Areli, the families of the Arelites. These are the families of the children of Gad, according to those who were numbered of them, 40,500. Now get what we're doing. We're getting a tally of all of the children of Israel, from 20 years old and under. These are the numbers. You got to understand, there was a lot more of them. There was a lot more children, people under 20 years old at that time that was not able to go to battle, and quite perhaps a lot that were too old to go to battle. So the ones he was numbering was 20 years old and up were those able to go out to battle. Well, you got to get this picture. We're getting a census. They were taking a census of all of the people, all of the children of Israel. Here we're giving their names. Moses was giving their names. We're going to read more names in our next session. But I want you to come back and be with us. Remember what we're doing. We're reading through this Bible verse by verse and chapter by chapter. If you stay with us, you will have read completely through this Bible verse by verse and chapter by chapter. You can always go to our archives. You can get them at my YouTube channel. If you remember Clinging to Him, go to YouTube, punch in Clinging to Him, or my name, Chester L. Figure Sr. That will come up. You can also go to my website, www.poemsbychester.com, go to where it says about to author, and you can contact me personally, and I will respond, or click on where it says The Word with Chester, and it will take you to my YouTube channel. I want you to know that I'm here for you. I want you to know that I love you with the love of the Lord. If you would like to contact me by mail, you can reach me at The Word with Chester Ministries, Post Office Box 200603, San Antonio, Texas. Remember, I love you, my friends. I love you with the love of the Lord. God bless you.